الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Al-Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Al-Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah, have the taqwa of Allah, and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. O Muslims, you've been blessed with the best deen and the best relationship between you and Allah and between you and the human beings. And this through Islam, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with it to be a way of life for you, not any other form of living. And this Islam is nothing but good, and everything in it is nothing but good, teaches you what is good. And one of the things that's supposed to be part of our characteristic as a believers, that we be fair, that we be just, that we have the khuluq of al-adl, to be fair and just in everything in our life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of his beautiful names, that he is al-adl. Although he is Allah, and he is al-hakam, and he is the judge, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just one. To such a degree that some people in the day of judgment will complain to Allah, we didn't get any warning, we didn't hear about Islam, we don't know anything about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them a fair trial. He is Allah. He knows if they lying or they are truthful. Nevertheless, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make test for them. Even some of the human beings will argue with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment, and they did not want the angels to be witness against them, or the earth will be witness against him or her, or so and so, and say, I'm not satisfied with anyone as a witness other than myself. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this moment, he will command the tongue to be silent. He could not speak anymore. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the limbs to be witness and to be uttering and talking. The hand will talk, the leg will talk. Your parts, your body parts will talk. اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون. That day we will seal their mouths, their tongues, and their hands will be witness concerning what they had earned and where they walk and where they went. And this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Malik al-Muluk, the kings of all kings, the king of all kings, still giving the people fair trial, although that some of them, they may are liar. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make your body parts to be witness against you in the day of judgment. And this to show you how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just and fair. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be fair and just. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah An-Nahl, Surah number 16, verse number 90, Allah saying, Inna Allah ya'muru bil adl. Inna Allah ya'muru bil adl. He commands justice, fair trials. Inna Allah ya'kum bil adl. Inna Allah ya'muru bil adl. Wa ita'i dhil qurba. وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان. Allah command you to be fair, to be just. What is عدل? And عدل have to be established when and where. Number one, the عدل with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be fair with Allah. As a result of this, he found the worst kind of sin that أن تشرك بالله تبارك وتعالى وهو الذي خلقك. that you set a partner or equal to Allah while Allah is the one who had created you. It's not fair. It's not just. That you call in other than Allah, or you worship other than Allah, or you hope and fear other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That you take from the human being, or from the mother nature, or from the righteous, or the awliya, a partner beside Allah. So number one, you have to be fair with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because He's the one who created you. الَّذِي خَلَقَكَ فَسَوَّاكَ فَعَدَلَكَ. He's the one who had created you, fashioned you, shaped you in the best form. So you be grateful and be thankful to Allah, and you don't set a partner beside Allah. You need to be fair with Allah. He gave you the ability to see. وَالَّذِي أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ. That He's the one who caused you to come from your mother wombs. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. And He's the one who gives you the ability of hearing and seeing. That you be grateful and thankful. But when you're using your eyes and your ears and all this what Allah gives you for reading and writing, things has nothing to do with Allah. Only because you're selfish. You're concerned about you getting your degree and you make more money. But you don't open the book of Allah. You open all the books every day. This is not fair. This is not fair. This is not adli. This is not just. You be a distance from the house of Allah, but you go all other places. You be distant from the book of Allah, but you read 16 and 17 full books every semester and every term. This is not fair. Islam about adl, justice. And Allah, inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wal ihsan. Indeed, Allah commands justice and fairness and goodness. Goodness comes in many forms. And the best form, أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. Worship Allah as if you are seeing Him. If you could not come to this realization, be aware that He sees you. Ihsan to the parents. Ihsan to yourself. Ihsan to your neighbor. Be good to everything. Even when you kill or you slaughter animal. إن الله كتب الإحسان على كل شيء. Indeed, Allah decree excellency over everything. So when you kill it proper, and when you slaughter it right, sharp your knife, relax your animal, don't be rough, even with animals. If Islam talks about animals not to be rough and be kind to them, what about your wife? What about your children? What about your neighbor? The ideology or the teaching of Islam, you could not find a better teaching. And Allah says that He commanding, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ. Allah command justice, fairness, and excellency. Why we always rush when we make a salah? Why you making four rak'at in less than 5 minutes? But when you sit down, try to solve a Jabra problem, or you're fixing your laptop, you can take hours and hours, and you insist that you're going to finish it, and you're going to reach the solution. But about the salah, you can slap any kind of salah. Throw it. Allah decreed excellency with everything. That you have to be, have husn, خلق, حسن التعامل, good way when you talk. And you be fair with everything. This is our deen. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربة. And those people who are related to you, that you be kind to them. You care for your need, your blood relationship, family ties. Don't servitize them. That is al qurba. Give them from what Allah gives you. Be kind to them. Visit them. Care for them. This is our deen. Inna Allah ya'muru bil adl wal ihsan wa ita'i dhil qurba. And also Allah yanha 'an al fahsha wal munkar wal baghi. Why Allah forbidding us from all these things? This is maw'idha, admonishment for us. So that we can reach the level of taqwa, that we can be among the pious one, the best nation that Allah had intended to be. We are not the best nation because we are Arab, neither because we are white or black, but when we carry out the orders of Allah. Not the Quran to remain on the shelf in writing and recite it when somebody died. But our action, our akhlaq, our behavior is totally different. Why? Be fair in everything. Give the people the rights and demand only what is yours. When we try to practice justice and fairness and be fair in everything, even when we talk, وَإِذَا قُلْتُمْ فَعْدِلُوا, that when you speak, when you talk, and just talk, be fair in what you're saying. Don't keep praising yourself and don't give credit to anybody else. Don't be witness for somebody that you don't know. You have to have fairness. Allah wants you to be fair in everything. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَأَعْدِلُوا بَيْنَ أَوْلَادِكُمْ. Fear Allah and be fair and just even between your children. Doesn't matter. I am the father. What I say goes. And you buy this one a toy for $50 and you buy the other person $5 toy. Your children. Yes, you are the father. But the Prophet ﷺ say, fear Allah, have the taqwa of Allah, and have justice between your children. Even some of the scholars say the way how you kiss and you hug your children. You did not kiss one child and keep hugging him, pampering him, and the other one you don't even, period. Nothing. We have to be fair. Same way you like all your children to love you, to respect you, you have to be fair with them. This is what is that Islam is and what is about. Even if this person that you are witness for or against is your own parents or your own father, you have to be fair. Don't measure for the people with two different measurements. For this one, you use this measurement. If it's done by Muslim, this will be terrorism. If it's done by non-Muslims, this will be an act of violence or somebody mentally sick or buried down. Don't even talk about it. We need fairness. In everything we present, we talk, when we deal with each other, this is what Islam is about. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbid an yamshi rajul fi al-na'l al-wahid. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbid a man to walk in one shoe. And also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam naha an al-qaz'. Qaz' is shaving part of your head and leaving the other without shaving. Some of the scholars say this is to teach the Muslim to be fair in everything. Because now you shaving your hair from here, but your hair you didn't. So you was not fair between your head, even your own head. He says not fair, you wearing one shoe and you are not even broke down. So wear both of them or take both of them off. Subhanallah. The Prophet telling you, your shoes is broken, take both of them off or wear both. Why? You have to learn justice. Don't bless or honor or respect one foot while the other one is not. don't you shave part of your hair, why not? So the Muslim will be always balanced and fair in everything that he's doing. If your family, the people you're giving, the people you're talking, in everything that you have to be fair. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Sahaba used to come with dispute with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet told him, "Nama ana basharun mislukum." Indeed, I'm a human being like you. When I judge between you, I judge according to what I hear, but I'm a human being. So if I judge one of you, can be more eloquent in what is the way how he speak. He have a good lawyer. He blessed with a tongue that he can talk, persuade and make you convinced that he's the one who hit me first. The Prophet said, I'm a human being. I don't see the unseen. So when I judge between you, I judge according to what I hear. So if I judge to one of you with the right of his brother, إِنَّمَا أَقْطَعْ لَهُ قِطْعَةً مِنَ النَّارِ أَقْطَعْ لَهُ قِطْعَةً مِنَ النَّارِ. Indeed, I'm giving him a piece of fire. Oh yeah. This 10 trees or this 10 acres is yours. He's a prophet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected him and he make him infallible, ma'soom, in the way of revelation. But about other things, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. I'm a human being. So I judge according what I hear. So one of you know how to talk better than the other. He have a better lawyer. So now I judge and say, okay, these trees are yours. He said, now if you know that this is not yours, and I give it to you, I'm giving you a piece of fire. So as a result of this, when this yaqeen and this adab of being adl and justice been there, that the Sahabi were ready to give up his home, fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need fairness in what we say, in what we do, how we act. And you know that these non-Muslims, when he passed by, he was a captive with the army of Muslims. And when he passed, he sees this man under the tree. And he said, is this Umar that you're talking about, that everybody scared from Umar? Laying down. Umar was working hard. He got tired. He lay down under a tree. What's the man saying? This is your Khalifa? Yeah. No bodyguards, no bulletproof cars, not this, not that, not heading, you could not reach to him. He take your money, he take your wife, he take anything because he's the head of the state. So what does the man say? Say, حَكَمْتَ فَعَدَلْتَ فَأَمِنْتَ فَنِمْتَ يَا عُمَرْ. You rule, but you rule justly, with fairness. As a result of this, you don't have any fear that somebody is going to attack you, or somebody is going to kidnap you, or somebody is going to poison you. Because you was fair and just a ruler, now you have the ability and the security in your heart that you can go lay down in a public area, under a tree, you are not worried about anything. Nowadays, most, if it's not all, our presidents and kings and princes and all these things, the door behind a door, behind a door, behind a door. You could not reach them. Why? Because the crimes that they're committing, because the injustice that they're doing, that there is no security in the blood, in the countries, there is no security. Why? Preferring black over white, or white over black, or giving jobs to certain people and not giving jobs to the others, or any kind of injustice, it causing trouble in the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he himself, and he is Allah capable to do anything. And he's saying what? Ya ibadi, inni haramtu zulma ala nafsi, wa ja'altu baynakum muharraman fala tadhalamu. O my slave servant, indeed, I forbid injustice. I forbid it for myself. He is Allah, but he's still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why Allah sending messengers? You have no excuse. I send a warning. He sent a book. So now you don't not say, I didn't know that you exist, that you're Allah, that you're only one. He made warners, preachers. He made everything available for you. He gave you the ability to know. This is fairness from Allah. He say, I don't wrong anyone, although I am Allah. So do not wrong one another. Don't be unfair to each other. Be fair. And you talk about people in their absence, you better talk the same way you're going to talk in their face if they are prisoners. Because what you're doing is not justice. It's not fairness. And deal with the people the same way you want the people to deal with you. The khuluq and the behavior of adl is something is very important, missing from our life in totality or in portion in some places. As a result of this, you see all these problems that we see nowadays. Prices going up, no jobs, disasters, name it, everything, violence. Why? Because there is no justice, is no fairness. Islam teaches us to be fair, and by trying to apply this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring about changing in this life by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I state what I state, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those people who fear Allah when they talk, when they judge between the people, and when we do any act that will be fair and just, and that we deal with the people in a mannerism that we like them to deal with us, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, wa salli wa sallim ala mab'uthi rahmatul alameen. Myself, Imam Adli, the Imam of this mosque, Columbia, South Carolina, in behalf of our center and in behalf of CIC, Carolina Islamic Council, in behalf of the Adli publication, condemn the acts of violent injustice committed in California. We extend our most sincere condolence to the loved ones of the victims. We beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make things easier for all of us and to guide us towards what is more positive for the future of everybody. I would like to apologize for last week that the books that I had prepared was not enough. For those who missed the free copy last week, please feel free to come to the table. You get a free copy of the book, Bid'ah and Common Mistakes. I would like to let you know that we still have the deal until today. This is the last day. Doesn't matter if you have money or not, you have your checkbook or not, that you can make a commitment for $200 for $1 of 100 and more to be donated to one of the masajid in the United States, so the people can revive their deen and the people can know about the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let your dollar be your way and your vehicle to Jannah by spreading the proper knowledge. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring the Muslim to a state that they can know what is right and to follow it and to see what is wrong and to stay away from it. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استووا واعتدلوا. Straight your lines, please. Shoulder to shoulder, foot to foot. Keep the line straight during the prayer. This apply to the sisters also. Get close to each other, sisters, and straighten your line. straighten the rank is part of the establishment of the prayer. استووا واعتدلوا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. القارعة ما القارعة وما أدراك ما القارعة يوم يكون الناس كالفراش المبثوث وتكون الجبال كالعهن المنفوش فأما من ثقلت موازينه فهو في عيشة راضية وأما من خفت موازينه فأمه هاوية وما أدراك ما هي نار حامية. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ألم تر كيف فعل ربك بأصحاب الفيل ألم يجعل كيدهم في تضليل وأرسل عليهم طيرا أبابيل ترميهم بحجارة من سجيل فجعلهم كعصف مأكول. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.